Good morning, dear students. Let's continue our chapter 2 of the supplementary reading, The Adventures of Toto by Ruskin Bond. Students, please open your textbook and come to page 8. We are on page 8 over here. Toto remained in the bag as far as Saharanpur, but while grandfather was producing his ticket at the railway turnstile, Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. Now, students, yesterday we saw that how Toto, an animal, was bought by Tonga driver. And after bringing him home, the author and the grandfather, both of them have kept it as secret from grandmother. They do not want to reveal it to grandmother, because they know that grandmother would not encourage. Well, yesterday saw how mischievous Toto, that monkey, had torn the author's blazer into pieces. Then they know that the pet is very naughty, very mischievous, and so therefore the grandfather decides to take him along with him when he was going to Dehradun. Now, what happens over here, as the ticket collector is asking for the ticket to grandfather to check his ticket, who is poking the head out? Toto is poking his head out. He comes out, he looks out from the bag and gave the ticket collector a wide grin. What is the meaning of wide grin? Gives a smile where his teeth could be seen. Then what happens? See. Now, Toto was kept as a secret, even in the bag at the railway station. Grandfather did not want to show it to the others. And we have seen in the previous paragraph, yesterday we saw that how Toto was jumping in the bag. Now, the poor man was taken aback. He was shocked, but with great presence of mind and much to grandfather's annoyance, he said, "Sir, you have a dog with you. You will have to pay for it accordingly." Now, the poor man was taken aback. With great presence of mind, as much to grandfather's annoyance, he said. Now, who is he? The ticket collector over here. And now, whom does he see? He has already seen the Toto, the monkey. But what he thinks? The ticket checker is thinking it is a dog. And so, what does he say? "Sir," with annoyance. Grandfather also is now a little bit irritated. Why is he irritated? Because he did not want a monkey to be shown at the railway station. And then what has happened? "Sir, you have a dog with you. You will have to pay for it accordingly." Now, the grandfather has to take a ticket even for Toto. And so, grandfather is a little bit annoyed. Not that he has to buy a ticket, but still, he did not want to reveal the presence of Toto. Then, in vain did grandfather take Toto out of the bag? In vain did he try to prove that a monkey did not qualify as a dog or even a quadruped? Toto was classified a dog by the ticket collector, and 3 rupees was the sum handed over as his fare. So, see students, when you go for the journey, if you are below 12, you have to pay half ticket, and then later on you pay the full ticket, isn't it? By ST bus, if you are traveling by ST bus and all, there is some concession for the children. Over here what happens? Even this monkey had to be paid. And how much fare is paid to them by the grandfather? 3 rupees sum. The money amounted rupees 3 was paid as his ticket, as his fare. Now, what is the meaning of "in vain did grandfather take Toto"? It was useless, in vain, that is V-A-I-N, that was in useless. It was useless that grandfather took Toto out of the bag. And he tried to prove that the monkey did not qualify as a dog. It wasn't a dog. Ticket collector thought it was a dog, but the grandfather is saying it is not a dog. Okay, whatever it is, but he had to pay rupees 3 as a ticket. Then, I'll come to the next paragraph. The grandfather, just to get his own back, took from his pocket a pet tortoise and said, "What must I pay for this? Since you charge for all animals." You see, we can see grandfather is a bit angry now. So what is he saying? He is removing his tortoise also from the pocket. And what is he saying? To whom does he say that? He is asking the ticket collector, "How much should I pay for this? Since you have been charging for all the animals, I even have a tortoise as my pet." The ticket collector looked closely at the tortoise, prodded it with his forefinger, gave grandfather a pleased and triumphant look and said, "No charge. It is not a dog." Students, what is the meaning of prodded over here? Poked. Okay? He touched, he prodded, he touched the tortoise. And what did he say? Who is he? The ticket collector. Ticket collector says that, "No charge. It is not a dog. It is such a small creature. And so therefore, you do not have to pay anything for tortoise." Now students, come to the next page and have a look at this picture. Have a look at this picture. You can see the railway station, Saharanpur. Ticket checker, ticket collector, grandfather, and you look at this toto. Okay, there are other people also. So just get the picture in your mind. Then come to the next paragraph. On the next paragraph, you see the different scene now. What is that? When Toto was finally accepted by grandmother, he was given a comfortable home in the stable where he had for a companion the family donkey Nana. On Toto's first night in the stable, grandfather paid him a visit to see if he was comfortable. To his surprise, he found Nana, without apparent cause, pulling at her halter and trying to keep her head as far as possible from a bundle of hay. Now, look at this, students. What is this? When Toto was finally accepted by grandmother, he was given a comfortable home in the stable. Now, you get to know that the picture, earlier Toto was not accepted. They had kept the secret from grandmother. But now grandmother has come to know and she has accepted Toto's presence in their house. But then what was decided? They had decided that to give him a comfortable home in the stable where the other animals were there, he had for a companion family donkey. And what was the name of the family donkey? Nana. On Toto's first night in the stable where the animals were put, grandfather paid him a visit to see if he was comfortable. Since he was a new animal and he was put it over there, he was given a different place now. Earlier he was where the author's room, from there he was tied up. But now where is he, students? He is in the stable with the other animal. And what is the name of the animal? Donkey, who was called as fondly Nana. Now, when grandfather went to see, what did he see there? He saw that, to his surprise, he found Nana without apparent cause, that is a clear cause, pulling at halter and trying to keep her head as far as possible from a bundle of hay. So the bundle of hay, normally the animal would like to eat the dried hay, dried grass. Okay? But then what happens over here? What is the meaning of halter? Halter over here is a harness. Okay? And so with the harness he's trying to keep his head little far possible as far as possible from the bundle of hay. Why? Let's see now. Why he is doing that? Why is donkey doing that? Even Nana is surprised what was happening to see. And then grandfather gave Nana a slap across her haunches. What is the meaning of haunches, students? Yesterday we have written all these meanings. Backside. And she chucked back. What is the meaning of chuck? She pulled back, dragging Toto with her. Now you must have got the idea where Toto was. He had fastened onto her long ears with his sharp little teeth. So, what is the meaning of fasten? Both of them were fixed together at a place. And so therefore, donkey, Nana was not comfortable at all. And where was he? He had fastened on her ears with his sharp teeth. Toto and Nana never became friends. Toto and Nana could never become friends. What happened? See, you see Toto is a mischievous animal. And so therefore, they both could not become friends. A great treat for Toto during cold winter evenings was the large bowl of warm water given him by grandmother for his bath. So what was that great treat? See students, you also when you get good result or when it's your birthday and all, your friends ask you to give a treat. And so a great treat, like a type of a party for Toto, was what during cold winter, when it was very cold in the winter, in the evening, was a large bowl of warm water given him by grandmother for his bath. So he would get a large bowl of water, warm water, for his bath. And what he used to do? Look here now, students. He would cunningly taste the temperature with his hand, then gradually step into the bath. First one foot, then the other, as he has seen me doing. Who is me here? The author. Until he was into the water up to his neck. Now, this is about the Toto. What he would do once the water was given? He would cunningly, what is the meaning of cunningly? Very cleverly test the temperature. Whether it's very hot, it's cold, accordingly, he will take the next step. Then gradually, that is slowly, step into the bath. Then he will go to have bath. First one foot and then the other, as he has seen me doing. So as the author used to do, and so the Toto, first he put his one leg and then the another one, until he was into the water up to his neck. What was the water level? Up to where, students? Till his neck. Whose neck, students? Toto's neck. Let's turn the page. Look here, students, now. Once comfortable, he would take the soap in his hands or feet and rub himself all over. When the water became cold, he would get out and run as quickly as he could to the kitchen fire in order to dry himself. If anyone laughed at him during this performance, Toto's feelings would be hurt and he would refuse to go on with his bath. One day, Toto nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive. See, all this mischievous behavior of this Toto. What? Once he's comfortable in the bathtub, we saw first one leg and then the another leg till the water is up to neck. And then what he would do? He would take the soap in his hand and or feet and rub himself all over. Then when the water became cold, he would get out and run as quickly as he could to the kitchen fire in order to dry himself. In winter, he would feel very cold. So what he would do? Again, go next to the fire to get the warmth of the fire, to get the little more heat of the fire. And then what he used to do? If anyone laughed at this time, when he used to do this performance, this all things were going on, and if anybody laughed, Toto used to feel hurt. His feelings would get hurt and he would refuse to go on with his bath. He would not go for his bath. He would say, like small children, he would say, I don't want to have bath. One day, Toto nearly succeeded in boiling himself alive. So, he succeeded boiling himself alive. How? We are going to see that tomorrow. Just now, I'm going to show you the question answers. Yesterday, I had given you only the meanings. Today, I have given you almost 10 to 12 questions. You have to write in one answer. So, pay attention at the board. Have a look at the board, students. I've given you the questions. There are 12 questions. You have to write today's date and write them in your fair book. Have a good day. See you tomorrow.